Okay, so we just keep going a little bit along here. That's good because it connects it to there. And then in a lift.
这条线非常重要，对他来讲就是他把这个画面的两个重要的部分连接在连了连在一起了。
要结构上啊，这个要反复推敲啊，所以我们初学者呢正好相反，不研究整体关系，只是在细节上反复的去抠啊，所以那个画呢就没有，就是气韵就不连贯。
Verticals are an important part of a painting.
一个画的点、线面啊，注意这个线的结构、长短、节奏、韵、宽窄啊，互相之间的距离的，注意这三笔，一笔长的，一笔中间的，一笔短的啊，中间这笔和长的这笔离的距离是正好短的那个的一倍啊，这样它的这个结构就出来了，不是随便画。
Can I get my bag? Oh, sorry. I want the dagger liner. Might be in there, but I mightn't have brought it. Let's see. Any brushes in there? This one.
刀笔.
These are great for doing lines on boats. Verticals are so important in a painting. Always look for verticals. Always look for verticals. They are so important.
他认为在这个画面里边，这个竖线是非常重要的。那这个怎么经营这个竖线是？
More paints. It's this one. More ribbons. Ah.
Give you caps.
For me? Ah, oh, fantastic. I like Paul. I like Paul Rubens. Where's the man for martini gone? No, they're all good. All the paints are good. All Chinese paints are very good. Now I'm being very diplomatic. They're all very good.
赫尔曼确实是画油画出身，你看他的用笔啊，刚才用干笔去扫那颜色，这都是油画技法，因为油画不干啊，好多是揉啊、扫啊，包括画这个，你看画这个这个桅杆这个线都是用干笔去蹭的这种啊，就是因为画水彩，一开始要画水彩的人呢，就是特别小心，造成因为老怕画坏了。 也就性子比较谨小慎微，抠细节，画油画出身的，因为油画不画坏，所以就糊了糊了的糊了的东西特别多啊。但也有那个有的水彩画家比较心狠手黑的，也是画的，画出来就画黑了的。
I love these red flags that you see on the boats. Oh, these paints are so bright. I will never ever use Daniel Smith again. These are much better. These are so strong.
He said, he mentioned the DS. He said, I don't use that color, I use your color. I'm going to compliment your color.
We might be up for low. I might get myself into trouble.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Yeah,
I'm not sure.荷兰的技师啊，也是这个体系的，
是吧？
啊，对，
你从他名字可以都看不出来，他这个色颜色的
是
颜色的名字，
他的对都是这么配的，所以他算起一个，他和这个温莎牛顿不一样。你看我们这一代人都是用温莎牛顿出身的，所以开始习惯。你看他有好多颜色，你比方说他这里边没有生者，
嗯，
就是那温莎牛顿比较好用的那些生者。
对他上今天上来就是找生者，没找到他就找了个折。但是水彩里边还是要有生者。
对，
土黄是不透明的。
没错，
生者是透明的。
对，他也没有土黄。
对，
他没有土黄，我用的那个也不
是
土黄。是
吧？
嗯，生者也没有。
你要是对
100多种颜色没有生者。
澳大利亚它有一个专门画派是叫透明水彩画派，就是世界上唯一的一个坚持只用透明水彩画，所以它那个色系里边就没有土黄，它不能用。他只用透明的，你像那个谁他们就是，
那不少颜色都不能用了。
对对对，
那群青也没有，湖蓝也没有。
群青有，
群青是不透明的。
Now, last but not least, are these foreground rocks.
嗯，而最后他要把这个岩石，这个石头块还是要加上。
There we go.What it does two things. It defines the bank, the wall, the concrete wall, but also draw some of these rocks.
You can see, this is in the writing of the book, it's not, it's just directly draw.那么很多是这样，你起了稿子也没用，起了稿子一盖就盖住了，对吧？所以说要大家，我还是要劝大家，尽管不太好玩，但是还是要画速写画素描，啊，你花上70%的功夫画素描速写，画30%画颜色画水彩就可以了，然后画出来事半功倍。我们好多人在那较劲。很多水彩，对吧？你实际上是耽误在素描，耽误在造型上。对画面的理解，对造型的那种理解，直接拿笔去画，你画不出来。
Blending it in, and then we're going to put some dark shadows where the rocks are.
就他认为这部分内容还不够重，所以再加一些重色。但这部分内容是慢慢融入。右边那个水里面的，所以他把刚才那部分打湿。
No questions?
大家没有问题吗
？Okay, I keep going.
是，可以用英文提问
哈。那你们不提问，我就继续画了。
对啊，你可以借机会秀一下英文啊。
Do 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 do. Oh, it's Oh, it's so hot here. This is where we need water.
这样构图上为什么这儿加一点呢？就是跟那个船啊。
Few dribbles, few runs.
啊，左边加点东西，右边船的体量很重啊，左边加点东西，这样呢，然后到上边又是左边，这样就形成一个之字形的一个 S 型的一个曲线，是吧？画面就不偏了。
Comes up a lot sharper on the screen than reality, because when I look on the screen, it's almost black and white. It's not quite as strong in reality.
嗯，我是看那个电视的画面呢。他说，因为它强化了这个效果，所以你看的就比较就是黑白比较分明，就是视觉的效果比较强。但是真正的画面没有那么应该是比较柔和的。
These paints are so strong, they're unbelievable, they're just amazing, they're really, I've never had paints as good as this, you know, like, you've got to be careful that you don't go too strong, because...
Are they more opaque like the others?
Yes, they are. But not all, the burnt sienna, I've got the Van Dyke brown, which is like a burnt sienna, I've never used Van Dyke, and it's fantastic, it's beautiful, it's those colours.
Is that less orangey?
It's a bit darker, but it's very similar. I can't tell the difference. They're excellent. Oh, sorry, I thought I was about to dance. Now.
大家把电话调成静音，好吧？别忘了，好吧？可能刚才我抱歉，我也忘了提醒大家了啊。咱们大家看一下。
Now and then the bank trying to but it was interesting. Is I love the way the ropes come down and then go up. And then maybe a little bit of.Texture on the bank, just a little bit. This is where dry brush is important.
要做一些肌理，在这个水泥的这块儿嘛，做一些肌理。
Getting the contour of the bank. See the contour. I'm enjoying this. I want to keep painting all day.
他说我很享受这个过程。我说我能在这画一天吗
？This is better than painting at home. My new studio. Thank you.
跟我自己的画室画一样感觉，很好。
Question.
北京的天空啊，最适合画水彩，在全中国。
调不出来吗？他要看看那个。
不，等一会儿我再调这个光线亮度。
他想看一下他那个。
亮度，背光对比度亮度啊，在这儿。
Oh, back again. It makes such a big difference in a painting. I recommend everyone do this. If you're painting outside or you're painting from a photo, look at your painting at the photo for at least half an hour before you start painting and working it out. It makes such a big difference rather than just painting when you get there.
他说要是大家出外写生的时候或者是在家画照片的时候 最好你在那个照片上看着看那照片的时候多花点时间，就是你花半个小时时间去看那个那张照片，怎么经营这张画面，要比你直接开始上来就画的话要好很多，而这个在最后的结果里面会造成很大的不同。
对，也这句话翻译成中文的意思就是说大家多研究一下是吧，别上来就画，一上来就画只能画细节。对，大家看到他画的时候他反复的在那儿反复的 在调整关系啊，研究那个关系，什么是关系呢，就是比方天空水面船那几块颜色，大概一个画面我们总说一个画面有三四个颜色啊，另外黑白灰色相纯度就这么几个调节钮，对吧，你这几个呢，另外当然行了，轮廓的虚实啊，这个也要调节，比方说我们说这个远处山和这个远景和近景的关系啊，这个呢你看照片都是清楚的啊，所以一定要加以调整这个虚实啊，把它概括到几个关系上，远近啊，虚实啊，色彩的这个对比和协调的关系啊。刚才看大家看他画那几个旗子的时候，不是照着那画，而这几个旗子的位置啊，就跟画那个船桅杆那个距离高低和粗细和轻重和缓急是一样的啊，就是它要有节奏。你看这旗子，那三个旗子就是它摆的啊，两个近，一高一低，一左一右啊，一上一下。最远处右边那个就下往下一点啊，上面两个离得近一点，就所有的东西都是这样。
These are great. They lead you into the painting. They're fantastic. Maybe another one there.Just to create something, not too many, but there, I can see them all there.
他说就是在经营，也是在经营画面上的这些想处理，所以他这两条线一画，他就是把视线从你这个画的前面引进去，所以这也是这个构图里边的需要。
画线的时候要肯定，啊，另外蘸水要少，一下想好了，擦一笔就画下来，有什么算什么啊，不要有一犹豫，那个线就性格。船桅杆也要肯定，想好了马上就画。刚才你看他补了两笔，为什么？刚才那个形啊，过于像成一个山形了，中间高，两头低了，两头低下来了，所以他补上，把左边又补了两根，这样呢就有参差了。啊，尽管注意，也还会有失误啊，就有想不到。所以就是这个关系呢是反复调整啊，注意啊是反复调整关系，而不是说在那儿描细节。大家注意没有，就是他在描细节上没有多大的功夫的。
And then for here, if I want more rocks, the hotel key.
哦，这都用上了啊。
Yeah, hotel number, anyone, number 708.
Oh, God.
Debbie's in there too.
good luck, Debbie.
Sorry. There we go. Just now. Yeah, love that. It's just fun, that part. I love this.Otherwise, I would have been finished an hour ago, so it gives me something to do.
就是他这个画画的比他平常的时间要多得多，就是他在那耗时间，就是在，但是他觉得还挺满意。就是要是他平常画的话，大概早就画完了。
I think, when you finish a painting, never finish, leave it to about 90%.Always important to leave it to 90%. Never finish a painting in one go, because what happens is your eyes get tired.
Leave 90%.
Yeah, finish it to about 95%. Yeah. You go.
Sorry.
Yeah, you go. Yeah.
他说在画这幅画的时候，他说大家一定要注意，就是别把它画全画完，画到90%、95%的时候停下来。不要把它全画完，这样的话应该是比较好的。
Because what happens is, yesterday I did a painting, And what I did was I was at this stage, and then I did something drastic to it because I thought it needed trees in front of the landscape. And then after looking at it 2 hours later, I realized I shouldn't have done, because your eyes get tired after 2 hours and you can't see anything anymore.
嗯，他就想给你们举个例子，然后他就说，他昨天画那画画的时候，他就是犯了一个错误。他说这个最后画到最后的话，他就是把一棵在前景里边的一棵树画上去了。他说他画完了以后，他怎么看这幅画，觉得最后那棵树不应该加上，因为他觉得他在这个画的过程里边已经画了两个小时在这张画上，所以他那个眼睛已经非常疲劳了，所以这个大脑也很疲劳，所以他觉得是应该加上这个树，但实际上在这张画上这个树是多余的，所以他觉得这种事情是会经常发生的。
So what I do is best thing if you're in a hurry, you want to finish it, take a photo with your camera or your iPad, and it shows up all the mistakes.
他说这个最好的检查办法就是在你画的刚才说到这个90%, 95%的时候，你大概就是拿你的相机去或者你的这个 iPad 拍一下，拍一下以后呢，这个一般的来讲，这个所有的这个问题和错误都会在这个上面显现得很清楚，所以这样的话呢，你就对你整个这个画面的处理和最后的这个效果有很大的帮助。
It's a bit like taking a photo of yourself. You think when you look in the mirror, you think you look one way, and then you get a photo of yourself.And it's totally different to the way you think you look. The eye does that. It gets used to an imagery. And then when it gets a new look at something, then you notice all the mistakes.
他就说这个我们平常在生活里边也会注意到，你看镜子看自己的形象的时候，和在你把自己拍成照片看照片的形象的时候是有区别的。所以这个时候实际上这个眼睛对这个画面的这个反应是不一样的。
那其实拍成照片主要是什么呀？就是等于是离远距离看，就是因为我们坐着画的时候啊，总是没有机会推远了看。因为其实在画室啊也什么，经常要把画放远处研究一下。那你坐在那儿画，懒得起来，你就拍张照片嘛。拍张照片就等于是全景，看全景。对你离远了，就等于是我们在一个大的范围内去看它，是吧？把它视角缩小了嘛，把一个小屏幕就是整体关系，看整体关系。实际还是一句话，就是研究整体关系，不是细节，是吧？大家注意，就是研究整体关系，少研究细节。
Just make that a bit darker. Oh, I can look up there. I don't even need to look at my camera. Yeah, make that stand out there. I've left enough white there, so there's no need to add any white paint. Maybe, there's something to do, because I'm not sure how long I'm supposed to take, but I'm enjoying it. Maybe just to break up that white area with some of them, and not too many.At this stage, I think I'm finished. So, are there any questions? No questions.
I said, 我这个基本上画完了，所以大家有什么问题没有？
Yeah, I'd like to thank Mr. Rubens for inspiring me.
我很感谢卢本斯对我的资助。
Sorry. Okay, so that's about it. Okay, thank you very much.